Yes, anyone, what is the full form of ICT? Information and Communication Technology. See, we are using so many technological tools nowadays, you know, to get the information and to communicate with each other. Very good, Chaitanya, very good, Raghav. So these we will discussing that what is this technology, where we are using. Sometimes, you know, we are using it, but we are not aware of that this is ICT. And the various devices which we are using for this technology, there is an elaborate description of those devices also, which help us to get the information and for communication. See, look here, ICT includes computers, the internet, broadcasting technology, like your radio and television. They are also a part of ICT. So ICT, it has not come just now recently with internet and computers. When we talk about radio and television, which existed so back also, so that is also a part of ICT because they broadcast the information for us. Okay. I will be speaking only the important points. Otherwise, you people have the book. So read the entire chapter carefully. People use technology every day at home and at workplace. Every day we are using the technology at home and at many places. So in this chapter, you will come aware that where you know you are using ICT and you don't even know. ICT tools enable anytime. We can use these tools anytime, anywhere to access information and resources. So various ICT tools that are used include computers we use at work. When we are using a computer, it means we are using ICT. That is information and communication technology. When we use a smartphone, that is also a part of ICT. So with the smartphone, we talk to each other, we get information. So it is an ICT tool. Internet is used for getting information, communication. We do through email, or we do a video call, or we do video conferencing, or our social networking sites, Facebook, Twitter and all. They help in communication. So this is a part of ICT. Now here they have given example. For example, to find a job, you may have to search the internet for job openings. Create a resume on a computer, then use email to send that. Send messages from your phone to communicate or appear for a telephonic interview. Get your offer letter through email. So through all these tools, you know, we are communicating anytime, anywhere, sitting at home. So they are a part of ICT. Then ICT helps us to communicate. It also helps us to run our business. See how ICT is helping in running our business. Yes, please let me know right in the chat window. How do you think ICT helps in running a business? Can you give me an example? Yes, I am waiting. No response. See, all of you know about e-shopping. E-shopping is an example where you run your business. Yes, Raghav has written. Ab jawab pe haan. Very good. When you make a website, you know, you are advertising your product. You can get the orders from there. So that is how, you know, your business is enhanced when you use ICT tools. Every company has a website where, you know, they give information about themselves. So that helps in business. Also, you know, like you do e-shopping, you go to the site where, you know, you can purchase products like Amazon and all. And that helps, of course, in business. So ICT also helps us in connecting with our family and friends. We stay connected even if our family members, they are staying far off from us, we can remain connected to them through these tools because they help us to communicate. Now, you know, schools are not opening, but still your classes are going on. You are able to communicate with your teachers. Teachers are going, are able to give you the lessons. Again, ICT is involved in that. So it is so helpful. Now, when we talk about information, information can be on papers. Like normally, you know, initially when we were not having internet, we used to go to the library to get some information on a topic. But now it is very handy. Using your smartphone or laptop, you can connect to the internet and you can get the information. So when this information is stored and recorded on electronic devices, so abhi jo ye information hai, it is on electronic devices. All your laptops, smartphones are electronic devices. So we call it as a digital information. So information which is on the electronic devices is also called digital information. ICT devices are, now what are the devices which help us, you know, in using all these facilities? They are the tablets, smartphones, laptops. So as a student, you know, you should be able to identify that what are the different devices in this picture. So I will just point out and you will write in the chat box that which device is this, what is this device called. Yes, this one. Okay, maybe some problem with the internet speed at your end or my end. Okay, tell me what is the name of this device, what is it called? Yes, very good, Chaitanya. Anybody else? Yes, Raghav, very good. Only these two, three students, Ayush, yes, very good. This is laptop. This is the laptop, it is ICT tool. Now I come to this. What is this device? What is this device? Yes. This is the mobile phone or the smartphone. Yes, very good. Now what is this? This is the tablet. Yes. This particular device is called a tab or a tablet. Yes. These are the three ICT devices which help us to avail the services. Now this is the picture of a modem which is used to create a network. Now, to use these devices, the ICT skills that you need are knowing how to operate computers. If you want to avail all these services, you should know how to operate these devices and how to browse the internet for collecting, storing, and disseminating information. So you should be able to browse. See, when we open the internet and we search different sites, that is called browsing the internet. You should be able to use these devices. You should know how to browse them for collecting the information. Then you should be able to store it, save it for future use, or disseminating means distributing it to the others. Now let us see what is the use of ICT at any workplace. At workplace, we use different computer software and applications complete tasks like making documents, calculations, tables, graphs, etc. See, at any workplace, if we are using any software, like we use MS Word to create documents, we make Excel sheet for doing calculations, we can make graphs in our Excel sheet, or we can create a presentation. So it is used at all the workplaces. Can also use applications to do everyday work like buying things. At any workplace, you know, any organization, it also has to buy things, booking train or bus tickets, internet banking, making online payments. So at workplace, we do all these different things. Modern ICT employs a variety of media forms. When we talk about ICT, we have different multimedia forms also on which we can work, like your text, graphics, animation, audio and video. So just now, you know, when we are communicating, there is audio involved, there is video involved, text, graphics, everything is involved in that. So therefore, at workplace, we use ICT for all these purposes. Now, how do we use ICT at home? See, mostly we have got television for entertainment. That is also an ICT tool. We have phones for calling other people. Now we have new devices such as smartphones. The smartphones, they are not only used for calling the other person, but we can use the internet connection to do various things. We can communicate, we can transfer videos, we can find information. We can create a social network with the help of Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. So we can use it for entertainment. Many uses of ICT at home also. Students, you know, they can attend YouTube lectures through YouTube video, or they can find information on the internet. So this is the use of ICT at home. Okay. Now, you know, we have various fields. As we talked that ICT is used in different areas also. So here different areas are talked about in this table, and what is the use of ICT there, and which website, you know, you can use to find more information related to this particular area or sector. Agriculture, retail, beauty and wellness, banking, apparels, logistics, healthcare. So this table is telling you that ICT is used almost in all areas. So it also tells you that these sites are suggestive. You can find information or with the help of other sites also. It is just an example. Okay, check your progress. The full form of ICT is information. It is communication here, not commuting. So this full form is wrong. Information and communication technology. Then second, live sports and news can only be shown using ICT. So live telecast are there. There, you know, it is the use of ICT only. Yes, very good, Ayush. Now I hope you people can answer these questions: two uses of ICT at home, emerging skills in ICT, key skills one should possess to use ICT, as it was discussed that you should know how to operate a computer, how to browse internet. So I will be giving you the assignment based on this chapter, then you can answer those questions. I hope all of you have done the previous assignment. I have given you that as a solved one. For keyboarding skills, please keep your registers complete. See, I would like to see in the chat window who have done the assignment of keyboarding skills in the register. If you have done, please write in the chat box that I have done it. Okay, very good, Nikita. I know there are a few very good students. Very good. See, otherwise, you know, you will have a lot of work will be accumulated. It is better to do the things together. All three means there were three assignments. This is the fourth one now for keyboarding skills. Only 4 or 5 students have replied. What about rest? Okay, now we will be discussing about the ICT tools, smartphones and tablets. They are becoming more important and more useful. Why smartphone is becoming so common? Because it is a small device and it can do many things. That's why almost everyone possesses a smartphone nowadays. So what all you can do? You can send emails, you can send messages, share pictures, you can call someone, you can browse the internet, you can view the information, you can connect to your social networking sites. A lot of things you can do with the help of your smartphone. So smartphones helps us to stay connected with social media and exchange information. So it is becoming so popular nowadays. Now this is a smartphone. It is an ICT tool for talking to people. I think mobile phone is only used for talking. Now when we talk about smartphone, they are more advanced. They are not only used for making a call, but you can send mails, you can make video calls, you can play games, listen to music, surf internet, open your social networking sites like Facebook and all, stay connected with others. You can use them anywhere. They are small devices at home, in office or on road. And also you do not need a telephone line. It is just wireless mobile. So it is becoming so popular. And the smartphones, they use the operating system. It may be Android operating system, or if it is Apple mobile, it will use iOS. And there are some mobiles who use Windows operating system also. Now if we come to tablets, for some activities such as reading a book for a long time, you know, the screen of the mobile is too small. So we use a tablet in those cases, you know, where we have to do a lot of reading or we want to get a bigger screen for doing our work. So in those cases, a tablet is very useful. It is like a mini computer with input, output and processing functions, and it has touch screen also. Like you can touch the apps and you can open them. The difference is that it is bigger than a smartphone. And you can perform all the functions that can perform on a computer or a smartphone. See, again, it is smaller than laptop or a computer, but it is bigger than a smartphone. So if we want a bigger screen to do the things, we use a tablet. Then your TV and radio, they are also ICT tools. Radio is used to broadcast audio only, and TV is used to broadcast audio as well as visual information to people. Both are mainly used for entertainment, but nowadays, you know, you have smart TVs also. The smart TVs, you can connect to the internet, you can play YouTube videos on it, you can connect it to various digital platforms. But the TV has become smarter. Now, many times you have heard about the word app, that install this app. So app is the short form for application. So when you want to do a particular thing, suppose you want to play a game on your smartphone, or you want photo editor, so you have various apps for doing that. And what is an app? An app is a software application. It is a software which you install on your smartphone or tab, which will do a particular thing. Say if you have installed MS Word, even your MS Word and Excel, can install on your smartphone. Many students told me that we don't have the laptop, so we cannot do the holiday super. But it is possible to do it on the smartphone also. You can install them, these apps, on your smartphone and you can work in them. So apps are the software applications for a particular thing. You want to make a collage, you have an app for that. You can make a video with the help of an app. So these apps are provided depending on what software is there on your operating system is there on your smartphone. As we discussed that mostly, you know, you have the Android. With the Android, you have Google Play Store. And if you have Apple, then you have the iOS operating system. You have the Apple App Store. You download the apps which are available in that operating system and use them on your mobile. Apps or software programs. A set of instructions or set of modules or procedures that allow for a certain type of computer operation. When you want to do a particular thing, you need to have that app on that. Now, like you are attending the Zoom classes, which the school is conducting. For that, you people must have installed the Zoom app on your smartphone. So without a particular app, you cannot use it. कुछ भी आपको करना है पहले उससे रिलेटेड एक ऐप आपको इंस्टॉल करनी पड़ेगी तब आप उस तरह का काम कर सकते हैं. So some of the apps are already present. As soon as suppose you buy a new phone or a new tab and you switch it on, the operating system is loaded and there are some default apps. Default apps means which you don't have to install. They are present automatically. When you get it, they are automatically there. So those are the default apps which are required by the phone to function. And other special purpose, if you want to do something special, then you have to install the apps for that. And you can have them from online stores like Google Play Store for Android and Apple App Store for Apple. So if you install an app from the Play Store, most of them are free of cost. But some apps you have to purchase. Yes, Father, correct. Commonly found applications, default apps. These are the default apps which are already present. Which you don't have to install. Default उसको कहते हैं जो automatically होता है. इसको आपको install करना, specially install नहीं करना पड़े, वो होता है default. जैसे आप जैसे ही on करेंगे, phone आपको app मिलेगी ताकि आप phone calls कर सकें. Camera is automatically installed. Then the mailbox is there to send emails. Then calendar app is there for maintaining your appointments and reminders on the calendar. Then you have photos, blog, then Google Maps is there, then messages, music, web browser, Google Play Store, Apple Store. So these are the default apps. Yes, very good, Raghav. Camera, phone. ये सब आपको install नहीं करना पड़ता, ये अपने आप ही होता है, इसे default app बोलते हैं. So, like you know, in MCQ you can get the name of various apps and you have to choose the default app. Now I hope you have understood that what do you mean by default app, and from where you can install some other special app that also you know now from Google Play Store or Apple Store. Now just look at the difference between smartphone and a tablet. Main use of a smartphone. It is mainly used as a phone. सबसे पहली requirement जब भी हम smartphone खरीदते हैं वो यही होती है कि हमें phone करना है, किसी और काम के लिए नहीं खरीदते. इसका main use है, it has to be used as a phone. Talk to other people, to make a phone call. इसके साथ हमें additional feature मिलते हैं जैसे कि camera. अब ये नहीं है कि मुझे camera चाहिए, I want to take pictures and I go to the market and buy a smartphone. So if my main purpose is to click the pictures, I will purchase a camera. The main purpose of a smartphone is to make calls, but we get some additional features such as camera. Can have use internet connection for communication. I can make connection with the social networking sites and all the work. But the main purpose is to make calls. Now if we purchase a tab as a wireless portable personal computer, I will purchase a tab when I have a requirement for a laptop. I want to, you know, I want a bigger screen to do various things. I want to work on MS Word, MS Office. Then I will go for a tab. Then if you look at the screen size is smaller in smartphone, it is bigger in tab. See, you may get a question that this is the requirement. A person, you know, he wants to read a lot of books. He wants a bigger screen. He cannot purchase a laptop. Suggest which device he should purchase. So you should know when to buy a smartphone and when to buy a tab. In a phone, you know, watching a movie or making a picture is difficult, which is easy in a tab. Then battery life, you need to charge a phone more often, whereas the battery life of tab is much longer. Yes, Kindle, you know, very good. Chaitanya is saying, Kindle is a site. Where, you know, you have got various books which you can read. So if you more often you have a reading habit, that will be very easy for you. Then storage. A mobile phone also has a storage capacity. High storage are costly, but the storage, if you buy a memory chip, you know, install a memory chip, or you go for a smartphone which has a bigger memory size, it will become costly. But tab, they have higher storage capacity and they can store more pics and videos. This was the difference between a smartphone and a tab. The symbols we have discussed just now. You have to identify the symbols. Yes, this one. What is it? Please, I'm waiting. Write in the chat box. Yes, very good, Ayush. This symbol is for phone. This symbol is used when we want to make a phone call. Yes, Nikita, very good. Now this one. E-part, yes, Radha, very good. Radha, we have two answers written. First is phone, second is calendar. Yes, Ayush, calendar. This is a symbol for calendar. So, calendar ka kya use hai? Isme koi bhi aap reminders ya appointments, kuch bhi apna calendar maintain kar sakte hain. So, then, you know, store your schedule. Very good. Yes, Radha, very good. Next one, C-part. Lakshita, yes, music, very good. This is music, not birth dates. It's a symbol for music. Yes, very good. Lakshita, next one, D, clock. Yes, C is music, D is clock. Very good. In clock, you know, you can set the alarms. Yes, you can set the alarms. You can set the time. You can also view the time of other countries. Then what is the time now? You can set the countries and clock will show what is the time at that place. So, bahut se uses hote hain jo hame pata bhi nahi hota. Yes, next one, Eva. Eva is gallery or photos. Yes, photos. Yes, F part. Messages. Very good, Akshita. Yes, Sagar, Chaitanya. So these are the few students who are active when I am taking the class. Others are just sleeping and some are, they have not even joined the meeting. I will be sharing the recording of this meeting today because it was off time. So they can see the recording and even you people can also go through the recording. So these are all the default apps we were talking about. Then I hope all of you now know the difference between a smartphone and a tablet. Now here they are discussing about the layout. मोबाइल फोन सबको यूज करना आता है स्मार्टफोन, उसके डिफरेंट पार्ट्स किसको क्या कहते हैं एंड व्हाट इज इट्स यूज इज रिटन डाउन. सी पावर बटन, इट इज यूज टू स्टार्ट और शट डाउन अ मोबाइल डिवाइस. दिस इज योर पावर बटन. देन स्क्रीन, this is the entire, this is the screen where you can do what all you are doing. Also, you know, you can perform the functions by touching these, or to the smartphone we have the touch screens. Then we have the back button, which helps us to go to the previous screen which we were viewing for an application. This is your back button. Then microphone, here is the microphone of the mobile present. So when we speak from here, you know, your voice is sent to the receiver. It is mostly tall. The buttons may vary from the model of the mobile to mobile, but normally it is like this. Here, this place is your microphone. Then menu button, this is your menu to get various options for a particular app. Then you have the home button, this one, center one, this is called the home button. This brings you back to the home screen from where you, wherever you are. You can press it to come back to the home screen. Earpiece, this helps you to listen to your voice calls. Here you have the earpiece from where the sound is coming. So you can see your, say that this is your speaker. Then you have the volume button to increase or decrease the volume. It may be present on this side only for some mobiles. It may be on this side. So these are the main buttons of your mobile. Many you may be using, sometimes we don't know where is the location of the microphone or the earpiece. I hope everybody knows now. So today we have discussed what is ICT, what all is involved in that. You can use it at workplace, at home, and what are the devices which are used for ICT. And we have studied the difference between mobile phone and tab and the various parts of a mobile. So students, this is all for today. And I hope that you people, those who have not completed, they will complete their assignment of coding skills. And from the next class, I will start from here, the basic features of a mobile device. Okay, anybody wants to ask, you can write in the chat window. Achha, books beta bilkul bad rahi hai, binding ke liye chali rahi hai. I will let you know when the books are ready. Can purchase them from the school bookshop, which is just adjacent to the school. Mr. Shahid is saying voice is not coming. Is it not coming? Please, all of you, my internet connection is on. Which coding? Yes, Chaitanya, which coding you want to do in computer? You are not doing any coding. These assignments are the written theory work that is to be done in the register only. So is that okay with anyone? Any other doubts?